गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 5 ऑफ साइंस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो चैप्टर 5 इज एसिड, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. सो हियर यू आर सीइंग द एसिड, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. थ्री पिक्चर्स आर गिवन हियर. फर्स्ट वन इज लेमन, सेकंड वन इज बेकिंग सोडा, थर्ड वन इज सॉल्ट. सो हैव यू टेस्टेड ऑल ऑफ दिस? आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू हैव टेस्टेड दिस थ्री. So lemon, the taste of lemon is sour. Sour means in Odia khatta. Then the taste of baking soda is bitter. Bitter means pitta. Then the taste of salt is salty. That one you are telling as lunia. So these are three tastes. And why these tastes are different? The taste of all these three are different. And what is the taste related to this acids, bases and salt? So let's see. So these tastes are related to the acid, bases and salt, and how these are related we'll see in this chapter. So let's see. So here in the screen you are seeing the substances are given, different types of substances, and their tastes are written. So first one is lemon juice. Lemon juice tastes sour. Next is orange juice. Orange juice also sour. Sometimes it tastes also sweet. Then vinegar. Vinegar, your mother is using vinegar in home. That vinegar tastes sour. Means khatta. So vinegar is used in making pickle and different items like that. Curd is used for eating and making different things. And this curd also tastes sour. Means curd means dahi. Then tamarind is what? Tenturi. That tamarind also tasted sour. Next is sugar. The sugar tasted sweet. Common salt. Taste of common salt is salty. Amla. Amla is known as ona. Ona that you are telling in Odia, ona. That tasted also sour. Then baking soda. Baking soda, taste of baking soda is bitter. Then grapes. You have eaten grapes. Some grapes are sour. And some grapes are sweet. Then unripe mango. Mango which is not ripened. That is known as unripe mango. Means unripe means in Odia you can say concha. This unripe mango is sour. So next we'll go. Acids. This term is derived from the Latin word acer. Acer means sour, means khatta. So this acid term is derived from sour. So those substances means acids are sour in taste. So this is also written, acids are sour in taste. And example is curd, lemon juice, orange juice, vinegar, etc. So these are acidic in nature, means the property of acid, the chemical property of acid, that one is what? Acidic. This property is known as acidic. So now we'll see different acids or different acidic objects. So first one is vinegar. So they have some chemical name. The vinegar, the chemical name of vinegar is acetic acid. Next is this one you are showing, what it is showing here? Ant is biting the hand or the finger. So look at here, when ant is biting, then from its mouth two portion has come out. Those portions used to bite, that one is known as ant sting. When ant will bite, after that what we will get? We will get severe pain. That pain is due to this formic acid. So the ant secretes formic acid while biting, and due to that formic acid we get pain. Next is curd. Curd is made from milk, and this curd is also known as, the chemical name is lactic acid. Next is lemon and oranges. So these have also acid. This acid are known as citric acid. Next is spinach. This spinach is has contained an acid, that acid name is oxalic acid. Next, this is amla. Those you tell in Odia as ona. This amla contain ascorbic acid. This ascorbic acid is vitamin C. Next is tamarind. This tamarind is also known as tenthuli. The tamarind contain the acid tartaric acid. So these are the different chemical names of different acids. So you have to remember all these chemical name of acid. Next we'll go to bases. Bases are what? Bases are opposite of acid. So bases are bitter in taste, means they have bitter in taste, means bitter means pitta, and feel soapy on touching. Soapy term have come from the word that soap. You are using soap while bathing or while cleaning yourself. That time what you are doing, when you are touching or rubbing the soap with water, then bubbles are coming and your hands will become slippery due to that soapy nature. That slippery nature is known as soapy nature, and that type of feeling will get while touching the bases. Next is example is baking soda, soap, lime water. Here lime water is what? Lime water is, that lime means chuno. When chuno is added in water, that is known as lime water. So lime is added in water, lime water. Then milk of magnesia. When sometimes what is happening, your stomach is in trouble, means sometimes indigestion is happening or acidity is happening, so you, that time you are taking some, means doctor is suggesting some basic substance that is known as milk of magnesia, so that it can reduce your stomach problem. So this is milk of magnesia, and the chemical property of bases is what? Basic. So this is, bases are basic in nature. So let's see those examples. So first one is, this one is lime water, that one chuno pani what you used to say. Then this chemical name of lime water is calcium hydroxide. Again, next is window cleaner. Sometimes you are using window cleaner, so for cleaning window you are using window cleaner. That window cleaner is what? Ammonium hydroxide. Next is soap. So we are using soap to clean ourselves. So this soap is either sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. Next one is that milk of magnesia. This milk of magnesia is magnesium hydroxide. I want to give another example, like you are taking Eno when you have stomach problem. That Eno is also basic. Next, we have to recognize or identify the base and the acid. So for identifying the acid and base, we have some special substances, that is known as, those special substances are known as indicators. So we cannot always taste the acid or base. Some acid and some bases are very dangerous when we are tasting. It is harmful to our body and to our life. So we cannot taste always all the acid and bases. So what we are doing? We used to do some test to find out which one is acid and which is basic. So this for testing acid and basic substances, what we are using? Some special substances we are using. These special substances are known as indicators. These indicators, what they will do? They used to change their color. So what is the function of this indicator? They used to change the color when they are added to acidic or basic solutions. So example of indicators are turmeric, that one you are known as halodi, litmus paper or litmus solution, and China rose petals. China rose is what? That one is your mandara phulo. So these are all natural indicators. So all these are natural indicators, turmeric, litmus and rose petals, China rose petals. So next we'll go to litmus. Litmus is a natural dye. Dye does not mean death. Here dye means the color. So this litmus is a natural color. So litmus is extracted from lichens. These lichens, and they are purple in color in distilled water. When they are dissolved in distilled water, they used to give purple color, and it turns red in acidic solution. When litmus is dipped in acidic solution, what it will give? It will give the acidic, sorry, when the litmus paper is dipped in acidic solution, it will give red color. Then it turns blue, means litmus turns blue when it is dipped in basic solution. So it is available, already I had told, available in the form of solution or in the form of red and blue litmus paper. So both type of paper as there, litmus paper, red and blue litmus paper. By that we can know that we can find out which one is acid and which one is base. So these are the indicators. This is litmus is one type of indicator which help to find out the which help to find out or which help to which helps to identify which is acid substance and which is basic substance. Next you see, this is lichen, and from this lichen we get the litmus paper or litmus, and this is the litmus paper. Look at, one is red in color and one is blue in color. So this red is red color and blue color. When this red color paper is dipped in, this red color litmus paper is dipped in base, then it converts into or it turns out blue color. But if this red color is dipped in the acid, it does not change its color. Then when this litmus paper, blue color litmus paper, is dipped in acid, then it turns out or it changes into red color. But when this blue color litmus paper is dipped in the basis or basic solution, it does not change its color, and this is the acid and basic experiment. You can find out the acid and base solution, which one is acid and which one is base, by the litmus paper. And here the table is given, the test solution effect on red litmus paper and effect on blue litmus paper. So look at here, tap water has no effect, no red litmus cannot change red effect on red litmus is no effect, and effect on blue litmus paper has also no effect. Then look at detergent solution. So detergent solution is basic in nature, means it is base, so it turns into blue, it turns the red litmus paper into blue, but blue litmus paper has no change in detergent solution. Next, soap solution. Soap solution is that is red here. Red litmus paper turns into blue, but blue litmus paper has no effect or no change. Then see your shampoo. You are using shampoo. That shampoo is also changing the red litmus paper into blue, but it is not changing the blue litmus paper. So this shampoo is also a base solution or basic solution. Next, common salt solution. It has no effect, means no effect on red litmus paper and no effect on blue litmus paper, means this is neither base nor acid. Next, you see sugar solution. Sugar solution also, in sugar solution, red litmus paper has no effect and blue litmus paper has also not effect, not changed. So, sugar solution is also neither base nor acid. Next, we will go to vinegar. Vinegar has no effect. Vinegar has no effect on red litmus paper, but vinegar changes the blue litmus paper into red. So this is what? This is a acid. Next, lime water. Lime water turns the red litmus paper into blue, but it has no effect on blue litmus paper. So lime water is base. Next is lemon juice. Lemon juice has no effect on red litmus paper and it turns the blue litmus paper into red. So this is acid solution or acid. So all these are the effect of red litmus paper, effect of acid basic solution on red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. So on the basis of effect, how those solutions are affecting the litmus paper or changing the litmus paper, changing the color of litmus paper, we can find out that which solution is acidic in nature and which solution is basic in nature. But we have seen like common salt solution and sugar solution, they have not changed the red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. So they had no effect on both of these paper. So they are neither base nor acid. So what are they? They are known as neutral substances. Neutral means neither this side nor that side, means they are in the middle. So neutral substances are what? Substances which are neither acidic nor basic are called neutral substances. Sometimes in some discussion we have to take one side, or in some fight we are taking some portion. Means if we have to take one side, if we have to let opponent side, or we have our friend side. Like this, we have to take our side. Like that, if we are not taking any of the side, means we are remaining neutral. Like that, neutral substances are neither acidic nor basic, and they are called neutral substances because they are neither changing the blue litmus paper nor they are changing the red litmus paper. That's why they are known as neutral substances. They do not change the color of either red or blue litmus paper. Example is sugar solution, salt solution, distilled water. So this is sugar, which is a neutral substance. Then this is salt, which is also a neutral substance. And this is distilled water. Distilled water means pure water. And this is also a neutral substances. So this is the end of your video of part 1 of acid, bases and salt. So in the next class, in the next part, we'll discuss the different types of, means we'll experiment, we'll see the experiment, how these experiments are going on, means how we are seeing or how we are identifying the acid and base through by using different indicators. So that one we'll see and we'll finish this chapter. So let it be here. So thank you all.